People spend a lot of time trying to get perfect selections in Photoshop, but there's so many times when you don't even need to make a selection to do a perfect cutout. You're going to be amazed by what I'm going to show you right now using Blend If. And by the way, this is an excerpt from my brand new tutorial, Layers in Photoshop. I've got a limited time. I'm going to give 20% off. Check out the links underneath. Let's get started. So what we're going to do is we're going to use this image, blendif.psd, and it's a document with two layers. So we have our model in the background, and above we have a picture of a couple of pigeons with the background showing. So what we want to do is we want to blend these together. We basically want to extract them and do different things. So let me show you how you can do this without selections using Blend If. So if we start with the top layer and then we go down to the effects, and rather than choosing an effect, choose blend options, and it's going to pop this open. There's actually a couple of things I'm going to show you. I think you're going to find these quite interesting. So if you look down under Blend If, under Blending Options, you'll see this layer and the underlying layer. We've got shadows and highlights. So that means if we say this layer, that means the top layer. If we pull this away, it's going to start to hide the highlights. If we go the other way, it will hide the shadows and allow the layer to show underneath. So what we want to do is we want to hide this background. So we're going to take the arrows above, and it's going to hide the background. Let me just kind of move this so we can see a little bit better. It's a little hard to see there. Now look at these edges. They're very harsh, and we didn't quite get there. So what we want to do is see these triangles. We can split the triangle. If we hold down the Alt or the Option key, we can split that triangle. We can roll that back. Let me drag this back up to the corner again. And just hide that background. So essentially what we're doing is we're cutting out these birds without having to actually cut out the birds. And as you tweak in here, you can get a very, very precise background. Now there's other things we can do. Let me go further than that. So if we look at the underlying layer, if we pull the shadows up, notice we can start to show the darker areas from underneath. And now our model is actually above the birds. Why is that possible? Because the darker areas are now being pushed forward. So if we hit the Alt or the Option key and we split this, and let's get quite aggressive with this, we can go all the way up there. And look at that, we're actually showing our model. Now what we can do is combine that with what we did before. Let's take our whites, we roll back that background, hit that Alt or Option key to split that. And if you look at it now, we've extracted the birds. Obviously, we do a little bit better job here. Let's pull those in a little bit more. And pull that in. There we go. There. See what we're doing here? Look at this. And pull that right back. And at this point here, what we've done is we've perfectly cut out our model, but allowed those birds to actually be behind her. And the reason that's working is because underlying layer, we took the shadows and we pushed those to the front. And then we pulled this back to hide the highlight area. And so you can see how you can extract things using Blend If. It's incredibly powerful. So we just click OK to apply. So I'm curious if you learned anything. Let me know in the comments underneath. And I'd really love you to check out my new course, which is called Layers in Photoshop. And what it does is we go through a lot of projects. It's a little bit over 3 hours where I'm really showing you guys how to use layers in a creative way. Now, the first few tutorials, I'm going to break down the real basics of layers and using layer masks and things like that. So if you're new, you're going to understand what you're doing. And then even if you're more experienced, you're going to love the projects that we're going to do in a real world kind of a way. We're going to build some wonderful projects using layers, masks, blending modes, all those kind of things. And you're going to be really solid and confident with those by the time you're finished. Check out the link underneath, and also for the next just couple of days, we've got 20% off if you use the code. So anyway, guys, if you're new, consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. Do me a favor, hit that thumbs up. That's the like button. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.